Vice President Robredo and her running mate, Senator Kiko Pangilinan, are wooing voters, this time in Palo Leyte. Let's get an update now from our correspondent, Adrian Ayalin. Adrian, over to you.
Hi, Carmina. Vice President Lenny Robredo and running mate Senator Kiko Pangilinan are crisscrossing provinces here in Region 8. She just finished speaking before a crowd gathered here at the Boy Scout Monument in Palo Leyte. Robredo may have lost big time here in Leyte province, the home province of the mother of her rival, but her supporters vowed to make up for what happened in the 2016 vice presidential race. Former Senator Bongbong Marcos Jr. got more than 406,000 votes, while Robredo got 241,000 in Leyte province. In her speech in this province, where local officials have openly supported Marcos, Robredo told the crowd that she knows how difficult it was to organize a small rally, but she did not elaborate. She, however, said that even if she lost in Leyte province, she set aside politics and had the office of the vice president implement various projects as well as disaster assistance. For Senator Pangilinan, he joked about supporters convincing the Andes, or undecided, to become Desis, or Desidido, or decided. And at the same time, he made a serious pitch to end hunger, laying down his food security platform, Hello Pagkain, Goodbye Gutom. After speaking here in Palo, VP Lenny flew to Biliran province. Then this afternoon, she is back here in Leyte province in Ormoc City, capping her day with a grand people's rally in Borongan in eastern Samar province. Back to you, Carmina.
Thanks a lot, Adrian Ayalin. The camp of Vice President Lenny Robredo believes individual endorsements have more weight compared to endorsements of political parties. This after several members of Partido Reforma said they are sticking with Senator Panfilo Lacson after the party's president, Davao del Norte Representative Pantaleon Alvarez, backed Robredo.
Babaliktarin ko lang. Ganun din ang nangyari sa NUP, 'di ba? Ang NUP nagdeklara na meron daw silang ibang susuportahan, pero sa mga sumunod na araw, ang daming mga mismong presidente ng NUP at iba pang mga gobernador, 'di ba? Na member ng NUP nagsabi na ang susuportahan namin si Lenny Robredo. Ang pinangahawakan talaga namin dito, mukhang mas importante yung personal commitment.
Given the recent endorsements for Robredo's bid, her spokesperson, Barry Gutierrez, expects some positive news in terms of presidential preference surveys.
Tingin namin, klarong momentum ang nakikita nitong nakaraang mga linggo sa kampanya ni VP Lenny at ni Senator Kiko. Dahil itong mga malalaking survey firms na lumabas ng nakaraang mga linggo, hindi pa nakaka-capture yung sunod-sunod na malalaking mga rally ni VP Lenny. Hindi pa nakaka-capture yung pagdeklara ng suporta ng sunod-sunod na mga local leader sa iba't ibang bahagi ng bansa, lalo na sa Mindanao at sa Visayas.
Former Senator and billionaire Manny Villar leads his Nacionalista Party in backing the tandem of Ferdinand Marcos Jr. and Sara Duterte Carpio for the May 9 elections. In a statement, Villar said Marcos and Duterte's message of unity is crucial, especially in rebuilding the country from the pandemic. He also believes the two have the platform and qualifications needed to achieve that unity. Manny Villar's son, former Public Works Secretary Mark Villar, is running for senator under the uni team of Marcos and Duterte. Some Philippine transport groups pledge their support for the senatorial slate of the PDP Laban Cusi wing. These include the Liga ng Transportasyon at Operators ng Pilipinas and the Stop and Go Transport Coalition. In return, they ask that the senatorial bets delay the implementation of the Public Utility Vehicle Modernization Program.
Hindi naman po kami kasi nakausap, nakonsulta. At sana sa tulong nyo, Mr. Secretary, at sa opisina ni Ginoong Bilheca, sana po matulungan nyo po kami na at ang ating Pangulong Duterte ay isuspend muna. Yan lang naman po ang aming pakiusap. Maganda, pero napakaraming problema para sa amin. Dahil maraming mawawalan ng hanapbuhay. Ngayon pa lang marami nang nagpakilo ng kanilang mga sasakyan dahil nga hindi nila kaya yung mga proseso sa programa.